think this is any better. I don't know how the audio is gonna fucking come out. Fucking bullshit. I'm still gonna get here a bit. At least today, I kind of like, I was a bit more conscious of it all, waking up in the morning and stuff of that nature. Bingo! Go! Nice. Two days ago when I was working at this place, I almost quit and I almost got fired at the same time, so. Fucking hell, man. The old guard of hospitality needs to change. Second of all, I really need it, so I don't know how today's gonna go. I'm not gonna say anything. So I was gonna quit. Yesterday morning when I was working, I took a good half an hour to decide what to do before I came into work. Now, past jobs I would just walk out, just not come back. So I'm not planning anything. Yesterday I thought like whatever's gonna come my way this year. Do the day, do this week, get paid, and try to work really hard to get another job. I've had a few responses in that regard. Because the thing is, I'm like, no, things I have been talking about for a while, which I don't think I've gone into detail talk that much of what's wrong with this place. It's a hospitality thing, it's nothing to do with me or them, really, as people. But throughout the day, I kind of decided, hey, I've really got to make use of my time to work, to get another job. I made efforts, but I'm really going to get to it. So, if that makes sense. But within 5-10 minutes of working there, yesterday ended up being really fine. Like, Wednesday shift was just a fucking nightmare. Yesterday, which is Thursday shift, was actually a pleasant experience. Like, I'm not gonna say that I enjoyed it, but. But within 5-10 minutes of me working yesterday, you know what the owner said to me? They decided to sell the fucking business, so. Since they're selling it, which I don't know if I should go into detail now about it all, but I had to go to the toilet. So there's two things. The thing is about selling a business, it could happen straight away, it could happen within 3 months to that. I've been really sad because I have been meaning to kind of actually follow through on it. I probably won't talk about fully now, it's just a hospitality thing. Some places, like, each place you work at in a cafe or restaurant or hospitality, or any, I'm assuming any workplace actually, there's always going to be things wrong with it. But it's also the sort of like, there's things, you know what, it just comes with the deal and it should be not taken lightly. It's also these things like, it's just, yeah, you know, you're getting paid off just to put up with it, so. I don't hate the people, I don't hate the jobs, any of that shit, but. But, so it's the middle of October, and yeah. But. their management skills are fucking horrible. But I've had a few responses, you know, for interviews and stuff already, so I'm trying to do a bit of a responsible thing. When I get home tonight, I'm going to plan out the times. Today's Friday, so the weekend's coming up, so I don't know if it's the best idea for me to actually go around applying for work when the weekend's on. In most cafes and stuff, with, their busy period is the weekend, so... But what can you do, hey? Tonight, so it's all good. I think they kind of realised too, like, you know, I'll talk about this another time too, so, but. But who knows, I might actually just decide to write it out too, to like, to the new owner comes along. But, because it's a perfect location, besides the fact the cafe coffee's around here, which is fucking bullshit, but, you know, fuck you guys for that, but, so, at least think about it for Monday, because I've got Mondays and Tuesdays off, so. So I just want to get through today without causing problems and shit like that, but... Fuck, my teeth got to get cleaned too. But... Still on the fucking nomadic search of manual jobs, finding the right place. Also, following through, I'm growing a beard for a while. One is in hopes of trying to grow lag. Trying to grow this out a bit more. I might have to cut this down. Right. Really need a haircut. So now I'm getting sick and tired of wearing this fucking hat all the time too, but that's a different story. Awesome. So tonight when I get home, I'm gonna do hopefully finish up offloading this footage to the Google Docs. Try to keep on top of that. But you know, what else can I do? Obviously do my standard marketing thing. Hopefully do a couple of things for Reddit as well. Last night my new Facebook account got suspended again, so I'm gonna have to wait a while for that. I took a plan to kind of unless if I can try to organize some time to go somewhere else for the Wi-Fi and sit with it. Sit with that Wi-Fi and just get a few people on the board and do it like that. So that kind of makes sense. So I'll try to explain that again. So I go somewhere, download a Facebook, create a fake account, add some friends to it, just whatever amount I can do without pushing that sort of spam boundaries thing, and fuck it off. Invite a few people off too. But see what happens. So, but looking rainy too. generational gap. Level 2. Fuck, it's closed. It's fucking closed. Almost there. So. Also, I've got to buy a new belt too, so. One more cigarette, then I'm gonna start. Anyway, I'm not as tanned as I like it to be, but so Sunday morning at my I'm at my AA meeting I normally go to on Sunday mornings now. It's a year. I am growing a beard back. Hopefully this beard stays. I really need to get a haircut too. Anyway, I got my Peaky Blinders hat with me, so. But. What the fuck is that noise? Yeah. So it was a bunch of my. There's a gang of minor birds there. Like, I haven't seen my friend Oriana here in ages, so. The last 2 or 3 weeks, I've been telling myself she's not here today, I'll message her just to see where she's been, but. So, like, I'm sure she's okay, just busy, so. Not often she'll miss it more than 2 weeks in a row. What can I do? Sorry. Conflicted. It's supposed to be a philosophy day. Decided to spend most of the day just fucking editing the movie because there's a lot of footage there. It's gonna take me forever to do it. Anyway. The webcam's not gonna come until. Till next month sometime. It's just fine. I'm gonna get buyer's remorse. It's gonna be from getting a fucking camera that can't do shit for me. Asking some shrimp soon. Nobody else is here yet, I don't think. Long way to find out. There's a kangaroo statue up there too. Nobody's around. At all. Zero people. Shit, it's a bit hard. Some lamina lamp. nobody's here. Like, we're... like, it's really cool. I don't know about other countries or other areas of Australia, but honestly, it's normal for people to be here for half an hour before the actual meeting starts. So. Spit all over the camera. You know those birds are making fucking weird noises. Pretty cool, lavender. Fuck, I got nothing to say to it, nothing to do. This is inside one of the rooms, which we don't use, but at all. Obviously down there is like a car park. Another car park and all that. Like, where is everyone? Pretty sure the meeting starts don't get cancelled, so... so, it's a bit weird that nobody's here at all. Zero. I retract that. Someone just rocked up, pulling out that car. Click, click, Jack Gat. I'm in Moina Vale, so I want somewhere to have a cigarette. I used to work around here too. My first ever job around here, in recovery, was around here. So it's pretty cool actually. Really enjoyed that job actually. Ever since I've lost that, I didn't lose it, I quit, but ever since I left that job, fuck, it's just been job hunting ever since. Little, and I'm gonna film more around somewhere else. Alright, so I'm in a park and all that shit. like it's changed a little bit. So my first job in recovery was at a cafe here. It was actually a big, big cafe. Fuck, it was busy. But I'm here for actually a job interview somewhere else, so. Found it straight away in my car. I'm in Monavale. I got roughly about 40 minutes to half an hour. A job interview down the road somewhere. Without having access to a car for the shifts, I don't know if it's going to be worth it, but I'm going to check it out. May as well do some filming around Mona. So I'll come back after the job interview and walk around and stuff. So I just thought I'd get cigarettes, which took fucking 15 minutes at the counter to get, but I can wait. And from between, I'd say, North Narrabeen and Palm Beach, fucking hell, why personally, trust me. But anyway, so I see you guys. This is what I'm talking about, why people shoot. Can't even fucking escape the car park. Fucking bullshit. Get out of the fucking way. It's taking so long. Hurry up! Fucking bullshit. I don't know. Oh, come on, people. Shouldn't be hard. You costed me money with the petrol. I'm fucking thirsty. So dehydrated at the moment. I am so dehydrated. Nothing else is happening. They're all trying to leave like me. Darley Street exits. Oh, thank God. I'm out on the street. What else is happening? I know where the cafe is, and I got maybe 40 minutes to fuck around, so let's go exploring. Thank you. This is like a pathway here, so I'm not gonna go down that one, but I will walk around here, so. probably didn't make sense what I was doing around that beach and stuff. I was at Marineville, doing a job interview. So it went pretty good. They got a trial. Looks like it's going to go for gold. Well, give me time to think about it and stuff. It's kind of throwing my day around a little bit, which is fine. I'm going to do a little bit of a walk around the parkway area. It'll give me time to look for shit. So we'll go for gold, okay? See what we can find. I'm near, okay, so this area again, if you recognize it, okay, is this bike track closed? So the reason why I didn't walk, fucking wind, hang on. Now, I kind of just got in my car and just started driving off. It's kind of fucked up, like, I did the job interview, I got in the car, and I kind of just drove off. And I'm like, wasn't I supposed to go filming around there, but it's definitely fucking modern. Okay, oh. So, around here. Sorry about the wind. Get fucking mud everywhere. I don't have the right shoes on and anything. I don't think I've ever actually walked around here before. So fuck, I gotta piss. The reason, again, I'm doing this sort of like walks is to find weird and creepy shit, so. Which still kind of hasn't happened yet, but. But regardless, I'm having fun. I'm taking a piss at the moment, so. So, I've got roughly about an hour doing this, so I'm not going to go that far, but something, anyway, I'm going to flip the camera around and, soon, have a look, so, is that somebody's house down there, or what? Oh, right, I think that's a road. Anyway, some bike jumps there. Rubbish. Oh, that's a road. Oh. Some milk crates I can see. See what's around here, hey? Oh, golf course. Okay, that's bringing a golf course there. That's the golf club. So down, yeah. Over there's Manly. So not much there. Towers, Illuminati shit. It's cool. Maybe I have been down here, just not for years, I can't remember it. But, I keep forgetting, like, down there, I don't know if you can see it through the trees, but the golf course just there. And I know through there is, like, some water system shit there, so, I don't know the chances of actually finding freaky shit. But it's cool anyway, so I'm sure some city boys can love it. City boy, be able to love it. Here we go. Here's, you need a better view of the golf course instead. Oh, hang on. So, the bike track thing. Let's have a look at this sign. Bike riders take care, blind corners, right arseholes. Fucking hell. Fuck you. I'm going anyway, because last time that I was doing this, I had zero problems, so. But, you know me, I'm a little bitch, so I'm not going to start arguing. I'm going to play dumb. Of course, no trouble, and just fucking go. So, again, my chances are actually fine. Plus, today's Monday. Last time I went on a weekend and I had no problem, so. Again, I don't know. The chances of me actually finding weird shit is practically nil, so. And today I'm not supposed to be filming for my vlogs, but capturing life as it happens. So. There's a little pathway thing here, but kind of an explanation, and it has this fence thing. See this fence? It's like a water dam thing. There's like a little pathway thing along here. Look, I know I kind of make little jokes about the Illuminati and all that, but that is a joke though, but it's not really dodgy shit happening, so. Or is there? But if there is, I'm too dumb and retarded to be the one to expose it, so. That's just. At the end of the day, that's just the boundary line to their property, so. Oh, look at this. Oh, okay, so. I ended up being. I can recognise, I can tell. Up there a bit further the other day, so. And I didn't go because of the wetness to it. Another chance for myself. What I'm doing. I think it's around D1 of the Lagoons or Headlands. There was like a homeless, there was like a little homeless camp found, and so it just reminded me of my childhood. I've grown up around the area, and you can always find like homeless camps and stuff around, or gypsy shit. And over the years, not because of COVID, but just for whatever reason, they seem to be disappearing. So, I'm kind of just exploring the area. And plus, you know, being a slight fan of like scary shit on camera. The middle pole. Alright. Fuck yeah. That's probably from whatever side there. So, I've always been like a fan of like Rando Nautica. urban exploring and stuff of that nature. So, and I got some family that they just refuse to, family friends, so just like they refuse to leave like the city for some reason, but they find the bushland like fascinating. So, so may as well have a look around. So it's pretty cool, hey. Like I said, I'm not meant to be. It's not meant for scenic walkers, just people on bikes and shit. So, I can see a giant beehive too. Right there, see? That's a beehive thing. So, well, it's pretty scary, huh?